tell you what, Chris, I want to get under the skin of a spot and find out what's going on inside. I think we're going to make a spotcano to the cupboard of everything. I have the spotcano ingredients. Well, there we go, Xand. All the ingredients we need for a spotcano. You need to ascend to the elevated sebum dispensing area.
What, you mean climb that ladder?
Exactly.
Remember, sebum is the oily substance secreted by the sebaceous gland next to your pores and hair, and it keeps your skin and hairs waterproof.
Now it's time to get the sebum into that pore.
Here we go.
We need some bacteria, send it up. Now, sometimes bacteria can get into the sebum in your pores and they start to multiply, and that is the beginning of an infected spot.
That's good. Oh.
Yes! I got splattered, Xand! Brilliant! These are dead skin cells, and they mix with the sebum and block the pore. This spotcano is just like a spot. This is really what happens. Some of the flakes of dead skin are just flaking away, but some of the flakes get trapped and they block the pores. The bacteria are multiplying. The sebum is still being produced. Pressure's going up. Chris, I think it's about to blow. Spotcano! 3, 2, 1!
We've shown you there are two types of spot. They appear when your pores become clogged with dead skin cells, resulting in a whitehead, or if the dead skin cells are exposed to oxygen, a blackhead.
And as we saw, the inside of a spot is the perfect place for bacteria to multiply, leading to it getting infected and filled with pus.
But spots are normal. We all get them. And tempting as it is, try not to squeeze them.
Do you know what, Chris? I've decided that I quite like my spot after all, and I am gonna go to the mega splashy under the sea spectacular party. Come on, Mr. G.
Have a good time.